His Excellency the Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Cyprus, Mr. Nikos Christodoulidis, and His Excellency Sheikh Dr. Ahmed Nasser Al Mohammed Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah will now sign an MOU for the establishment of a joint cooperation committee. His Excellency the Minister of Transport, Communication and Work, Mr. Yanis Karousos, and His Excellency Sheikh Dr. Ahmed Nasser Al Mohammed Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah will now sign an MOU for the prevention of theft of illegal extractions and illegal import and export of cultural property. Press statements by the foreign ministers.
Dear friends, it gives me great pleasure to host today the visit of my esteemed colleague and very dear friend, the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Kuwait. Excellency, dear Ahmed, a very warm welcome to you and to all the members of your delegation to Cyprus. The conditions imposed on all of us by the pandemic making traveling a lot more complicated, and therefore the more grateful to Ahmed for his visit, which is a clear testament to the historic ties between our countries and reflect reflects our shared determination to drive relations forward to an even higher level. To this end, we have had very substantial and constructive discussions today, following up also on the deliberations we had during our last meeting in the margins of the UN General Assembly last September. Indeed, ties between Cyprus and Kuwait go all the way back to the independence of both of our countries. Cypriots remember with appreciation the generous support of Kuwait to the Committee of Missing Persons in Cyprus and to reconstruction projects undertaken in the aftermath of the Turkish invasion of the island back in 1974. There are clear affinities between our two countries based on our similar historical experiences as well as on our shared resolute commitment to the principles of the UN Charter and international law and to the importance of good neighborly relations. The signing of the two memorandum of understanding a few minutes ago, one on the establishment of a joint committee and one on preventing the illicit trafficking of cultural property, are a tangible manifestation of the political will and commitment of both our governments to elevate bilateral ties and cooperation to a new height for the benefit of the peoples of our countries and of our broader region as a whole. Within the same context, we also talk with Ahmed about the prospects of welcoming more students from Kuwait in our universities, about the benefits from establishing frequent political consultations, and we discuss ideas for generating new momentum in our trade, economic, and investment relations, like, for example, the export of traditional products like halloumi to Kuwait. Dear friends, we all know that geography is destiny. As a European Union member state closer to the Middle East and the Gulf region, we have in recent years made the enhanced engagement with all countries of our region, both at the bilateral but also on a unilateral and multilateral level, a top priority and a core pillar of Cyprus' foreign policy. Our efforts in this direction are inclusive and are always guided by a positive agenda of shared interests and synergies. I note with great satisfaction that these principles are very much shared and form a central tenet of Kuwait's outlook as well. Against this backdrop, we have also exchanged views today with Ahmed on a number of regional issues, such as the ongoing conflicts in Syria and Yemen, the situation in Lebanon, the prospects of a political transition in Libya. Kuwait's assessment on these topics is highly valued, particularly in view of its current presidency of the Arab League Council and its active role within the Gulf Cooperation Council. Cyprus has been long advocating for closer European Union engagement with all countries and multilateral organizations of the wider Middle East and Gulf region, which, as I always underline, forms an important part of the European Union's neighbourhood. As we keep saying in practice, time after time, European security and stability is interlinked with developments in this region. As you may expect then, European Union-Kuwait relations are also featured prominently in our deliberations. I reiterate our position that these ties are crucial in our joint efforts to successfully address the common challenges before us, and I have assured Ahmed that Kuwait can continue to rely on support from Cyprus in efforts to further enhance its bilateral cooperation with the European Union, including the country's inclusion in the visa waiver program. In the same vein, I'm particularly pleased that Ahmed has accepted my invitation for him to attend a working breakfast with the European Union foreign ministers that will be hosted by Cyprus in the margins of the upcoming Foreign Affairs Council of the European Union on January 24. This will provide an excellent opportunity for Kuwait's perspective on a number of issues to be heard in Brussels. Dear friends, on my part, I also had the opportunity to brief Ahmed on the latest developments in relation to the Cyprus problem, following on from the relevant discussion earlier with President Anastasiadis. I pointed out in particular that Turkey's provocative activities, both on land, in relation in particular to the fenced area of Famagusta, and at sea within the exclusive economic zone of Cyprus, are not only unlawful, but also have a negative impact on international efforts led by the UN Secretary General to reach a solution through the resumption of negotiations aimed at reuniting the island on the basis of the agreed framework. Dear Ahmed, in closing, I would like to once more to thank you for your visit today, for your friendship, as well as for the excellent cooperation we have had over these past few years, which I'm very pleased to note has served to bring our countries and our peoples even closer together than ever before. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, Tikanis, Kalispera, everybody. I'm really glad to be here. My dear friend, Nikos Christodoulos, the Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Cyprus. I'm glad to be here because we are celebrating 60 years of our diplomatic relationship, which really passed through good times and in hardship. And in hardship times, we truly did see in Cyprus a friend indeed is a friend in need. As we are also celebrating this year 30 years of the liberation of Kuwait, so we truly do recall fondly the principled stance of Cyprus with Kuwait during its darkest times. So thank you again from the His Highness the Emir and the people of Kuwait to your position. Today, as my brother Nico said, we have signed two important agreements, are added to the other 15 documents signed between both our countries. We truly do see that now it is the opportune time to further institutionalize our relationship in a very credible way. And that's why the creation of the joint committee, and so we can have a clearer indicator to gauge the level of progress between both our countries. We truly do see that we need to more focus on economic, commercial, and trade ties between both our countries. Nikos, you have said that you cannot change geography. Likewise, you cannot change history. We have a beautiful story, but I think we have even a brighter future. And with what we have signed today, we can forge a very credible and tangible plan that can pave the way forward for both our countries. Regarding what we have discussed in regional and international matters, Kuwait and Cyprus see eye to eye. We have the same values. All of these values emancipates from the UN Charter and the principles and purposes of UN Charter and international law. And we think that this is the way forward to solve all of the challenges around the world, and they are very much numerous. We have discussed a wide range of topics and issues, and from my part, I truly do thank you for the invitation to be here in Cyprus, but also the invitation to be present in the breakfast in the European Union, where I would have the opportunity to share the perspective of Kuwait's perception, I mean, of Kuwait towards regional issues on a national capacity, but also on the capacity as now chairing the Arabic League Foreign Ministers meeting. So thank you so much for receiving me. Thank you for the warmth and the welcome. And I think that today we are hopefully creating the future for both our countries. Thank you so much, Nikos.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thanks.